With just one quarter final remaining, the third and final round of the $500,000 Ultimate Bowls Championship has lived up to expectations. Broadbeach, the Port Melbourne Borough Boys and Team Exodus have all advanced to the semi-finals by virtue of producing world-class bowls.
Okay, Wilson, last bowl. What can you deliver? He's been a bit off with his first two bowls of this end, just sailing on the high side. Well, he's corrected the weight. What connection can he make here? Well, there you go. Nathan Wilson, you can't count him out.
Today, we present comprehensive coverage of quarterfinal number four between New Zealand's South Island Storm and Melbourne's Dandenong Club. Plus, there's a feature interview with two of the world's great players in Aron Sherriff and Aron Wilson that is simply not to be missed. Welcome to the Moama Bowling Club for the third and final round of the Ultimate Bowls event. Our coverage proudly presented by Ryman Healthcare, Sports Centre, Aero Bowls and the Moama Bowling Club.
It's great to have your company as our finals coverage of the Ultimate Bowls Championship continues. Now, I've managed to get this guy, Chris Green, out of the commentary box and in front of the camera to talk all things Ultimate Bowls. Now, Greeny, from commentating all of these games and watching it, what has been the main change for the players in getting their heads around this format?
Yeah, well, obviously the tactics have changed a lot from Warilla to now we're here at Moama. They were sort of a little bit defensive, if not in the first event, but now it's all about attacking. Every bowl can score points, and that's the vital thing. So even if you are in front, you want to get further in front. So I think it's all about the scoring, but a lot more aggression now.
And what do you think has contributed to the success of the Ultimate Bowls Championship?
Well, the massive buy-in from the franchise and the players. They've just grabbed it by both hands, and they've run with it. Like, there were a lot of changes. It's fun, it's fast, it's fresh. But the players, they've enjoyed themselves, and it's just made the event what it is.
And Greeny, looking back on the season that was, what has been a standout moment for you?
I think each event has its own standout moment. We go back to Warilla, we've got Gary Kelly playing the bomb for Dandenong. I think it was the quarter final. Barry Lester hat, it's still probably on the roof. And then you go to Deer Park, event two. That final, Dandenong Club and the point, just brilliant. I think the players, spectators, everyone involved and anyone who knows the UBC will just want to watch that over and over for years. So Moama now, I'm sure there's going to be another highlight.
Most definitely. These games are coming down to that final bowl. We can't wait to hear more expert commentary from Chris Green. Time to get back in the box and let's keep the finals action going.
And we're delighted to have Chris Green as our expert commentator on the television coverage of the Ultimate Bowls Championship. Thank you to Ebony 2, great preview, and thanks to you for joining us wherever you're watching around the world. You can see the three teams that have advanced to the semi-finals today in quarterfinal four. It'll be the South Island Storm or Dandenong. Let's start by recapping the highlights of the first three quarters.
Ryan Burnett, can he draw the shot here? He gets around the bowl and gets to the jack, and he takes the lead.
Fantastic.
3 points for a toucher. So the pace will change a little bit. Be up to the players there to jump on quickly. Great shot here, Wayne Rudiger.
Here we go.
Big weight, and what a shot. No jack movement. He's got the both bowls out clean. Rudiger in the heat. They need shot here. Need to convert this. Borough Boys with a hold shot. They'll move forward. Needs luck. He needs help off that front bowl. He slides through the gap. And it will be the Borough Boys who progress through to the semi-finals, as you can see by the smiles on those two boys' faces. There'll still be a target here, Aron Sherriff. Exodus is running, he'll be looking for the jack, and he's got the jack. He would have loved it in the middle.
So only 5 points in this, quarterfinal three.
Another very solid end here from John Green. Gets down for the jack. That'll be a further 3 points, and look at that margin. The point, currently one in front, but holding first and second. Aron Sherriff, big weight in his backhand. He's chasing it. He needs contact and a little bit of luck. He gets the contact. Blue ball onto the jack. Be looking to just get around the front, trail the jack here. Well, he's watching it. John Green's watching it. Lee Forsyth still watching it. We get down for the jack. Well, he just slides past. That won't be enough.
What a fantastic highlights package of the opening three quarterfinals. Some world-class bowls by many of the world's best exponents. Club Dandenong and their representatives, Barry Lester and Gary Kelly, and now Andrew Kelly and Roger Stevens on screen, who represent the South Island Storm in this fourth quarter final, and Chris Green, the South Island Storm. Well, this is their final series debut, and congratulations to them.
Absolutely. It's great to see a New Zealand side in the South Island Storm in the finals here at Moama. But can they take the next step? And in front of them, the Dandenong Club. We know Barry Lester and Gary Kelly, what they can provide. Andrew Kelly and Roger Stevens here on screen, they're going to need to get off to a great start. One of the big things that Dandenong Club have been able to do is score 22s, 24s, 26s on the first end of big matches. South Island Storm, they need to jump out of the gates and jump out quickly.
Yeah, tough assignment for the South Island Storm. Dandenong Club, arguably the benchmark, if you like, thus far in the inaugural Ultimate Bowls Championship. This man on screen, Barry Lester, the entertainer, has been in sublime touch throughout this tournament.
He's just been setting just the perfect platform for Gary Kelly, and we know the big bowls that Gary Kelly's played throughout events one and two, and once again here, event three at Moama, he just continues to deliver.
Five ends, of course. You can score on every bowl if this is the first time you've watched our coverage of the world's biggest bowls tournament.
Yeah, it's exciting. 3 points for touches, 3 points for holding shot at the crossover. The conclusion of end, if you hold the shot, that's 10 points. Second shot, 5 points. Third shot, 3 points. You get first, second, and third, and there's your ultimate end, 18 points.
Kelly and Lester, animated as always. Great shot, and the crowd really building here too as we advance to the nighttime session. Tremendous atmosphere. These players putting it all on the line.
Hold on, mate. Hold on.
Yeah, the third member of this South Island Storm team is Roger's wife, Bronwyn Stevens. Great supporters of bowls in New Zealand and also the UBC.
And Bronwyn has been a very versatile sportswoman. A former silver medalist at the 2015 World Powerlifting Championships in Finland. In addition to her bowls exploits, look at this. Lead shot, Dandenong, three up.
So first to hit the scoreboard, Dandenong Club, that man on screen, Barry Lester. First bowl just heading through, but look at this, second and third bowls. That's what we come to expect from Barry Lester. One of the best leads in Australia, if not the world. He's got his own wine on the back of his shirt as well, the blessed wine.
I haven't had the pleasure. If you get to watch this coverage, Barry, that was a hint. As the action continues, important for the South Island Storm to get off to the best possible start.
Absolutely vital, Tappy. These boys in dark blue, they can score and score big numbers in the first couple of ends, and quite often it really guides them to winning the matches. They might not have their best ends in their third and fourth, but the first and second, they really jump out nice and quickly and apply that pressure and the scoreboard pressure.
There's the dates on screen for the 2020 Ultimate Bowls Championship. Deer Park in April, Warrilla on the New South Wales South Coast, August 13, 14. Then back here to this wonderful venue at Moama, December 10 and 11, 2020.
once again, just missing his line there. Just a touch high. He had the right weight, and he just touched it up a little bit. He could have landed the bowl, trailed the jack back to his own two as well. But as it stands, first and second shot here for Dandenong. Kelly be looking to add a third here to hold the ultimate end first up. Can he get to the jack? Can he get to the jack? Oh, yes, he can. Please. A further 3 points, first, second, and third. Big bowl coming up here for Kelly.
Stop it. Honestly, the skill level in this championship is remarkable. That's a great shot, isn't it? As we now zoom in, follow the track of the bowl.
He needs to hold past that front. Unfortunately, just collecting that front bowl. Kelly, he can add further points here, but only by getting a toucher. Already holding first, second, and third, so the ultimate end. Issue, though, if he grabs a toucher, he doesn't want to move it any closer to the blue bowls. Great start here for Dandenong Club. Exactly what we come to expect, Tappy. South Island Storm, it's all in front of them now. Another four ends to go, but they're going to be trailing at least 24-0. What a great effort that was, Gary Kelly. Well, that's a sign of things to come. South Island Storm could be in a bit of hurt here.
Ooh, yeah. That's not what the doctor ordered. We talked about the need for them to get off to a good start playing this Dandenong Club. And that hasn't transpired, sadly, but it's early days. As you look at a replay montage of some of the shots in that opening end of the fourth quarter final here at the Moama Bowling Club. And how good is this championship?
Thanks, guys. Yes, that was a tough start for the South Island Storm, but I'm sure they'll get on the board when we return with more from the Ultimate Bowls Championship right after this quick break.
Aron and Aron, do you like standing shoulder to shoulder like this? You go first, Aron.
Yeah, no, I love it. Disco's a great friend of mine, and I don't mind bumping shoulders with him.
And you feel the same way, Aron, about Aron?
Yeah, look, he's a... I don't know.
Your all-time favourite movie, what is it?
Oh, God. I'm a bit of a Transformers fan, so I don't mind me Transformers, but I'm also into the sports stuff, so Coach Carter, things like that, they're cool.
All right, and Aron, your favourite television show of all time? Geez,
you give me the easy question here. I'm a SpongeBob fan. So it's pretty impressive.
SpongeBob SquarePants. Yeah, that's
yeah, all. Yeah, so if you want to see, I've got the box series at home for you.
Aron, your favourite colour?
Go with my daughter's favourite colour as well, that's green.
Aron, your favourite female movie star of all time?
Yes. Get back to me.
Hey, can you get back to me, please?
Yeah, you got to get it. Come on.
Aron, your favourite food?
Love a Thai feed. Peanuts. My son's got an allergy, so do it on tour.
All right. And Aron, what was the last movie you saw?
Last movie, The Dirty Grandpa.
All right. And Aron, if you can just get yourself back together here. Yeah. If you could be an elite sports person in any genre, doesn't matter what it is, if there were no rules and you could have any wish you wanted, who are you?
I mean, if we're going sport, like Roger Federer, he's the man. He's probably an idol of mine. So, if I'm going to be a clean skin, Roger would be the one.
Aron, if you were an astronaut, what planet would you want to go to?
Planet? Oh, I'd go back here. It's got a lot of good stuff going for it.
Uranus. But you're already here.
Yeah.
The whole idea is to go somewhere.
All right, I'll go to Uranus.
Thanks for your time, guys. Good to have your company, wherever you might be watching around the world. Welcome back to the Moama Bowling Club. And quarterfinal number four between the South Island Storm and Dandenong Club. And Dandenong Club, the winner of the opening round of this championship at Warilla, and then the runner-up in event two at Deer Park, lead by 24 to zip.
Yes, absolutely clinical, as we've come to expect from these two boys on screen. Their third member of the side, Wayne Turley, the Dandenong Club. They're just setting the UBC alight. But South Island Storm, it's great to see them in the finals. And we've still got four ends to go in this quarterfinal match, so anything's possible. The scoring opportunities allows you to come from behind 24-0, yep. But that's very hard to do against the Dandenong Club.
Indeed. So Roger Stevens in action again from the Tarangi Bowling Club in New Zealand. Has had plenty of success at domestic level in his native New Zealand. Barry Lester, what a 2019 this player enjoyed. You see the study of concentration. And his teammate happy with that.
Yeah, he followed up a big 2018 where he was a dual silver medalist at the Commonwealth Games on the Gold Coast. And Gary Kelly also at those Commonwealth Games playing for Northern Ireland. Now he's moved out here to play for the Warilla Club. We're our hosts of event one. We'll be event two in 2020. Good shot here, Roger Stevens. Almost getting the first points on the board there for South Island Storm, but he does hold first shot.
It's certainly a good opportunity for Stevens and Kelly coming up against this pair. And I know you alluded to it earlier. You know, Lester and Kelly have been arguably the two most outstanding players consistently in this event in its inaugural season. So it's a great opportunity for Andrew and Roger to see exactly where they're at.
Oh, 100%. That's what you want to do. You want to play the best. You learn their tactics as well, and you just see the little bits and pieces they do, the little one-percenters. Baz is all about the one-percenters. Even as far as him and Gary, they always get their haircuts done before each event. They get it done exactly the same, except Gaz has the big beard on. They're a pretty tight-knit team, the boys.
I do get emotional when people start talking about hair and haircuts particularly, you know that.
Great shot here, Roger Stevens. So that will be 6 points, 3 for the touches, 3 for the crossover. Just what the South Island Storm needed.
So Gary Kelly strolls toward the mat. Produced one of the greatest bowls the sport has ever seen back in the opening round of this title at Warilla. And we saw some vision of that earlier in the show. You alluded to it in your preview piece with Ebony. People are still talking about the that bowl.
Yeah, definite highlight for the UBC. Gary Kelly, can he get, once again, delivers the goods.
What can't he do? Stop it again.
See, Roger Stevens, he would have just had his confidence sky high. He played a fantastic end. He grabbed 6 points for his side. But then Gary Kelly comes down and delivers that. Andrew Kelly here, South Island Storm, playing weight on his forehand, looking for connection with the blue through it. He does. He opens it right up. Almost grabbed a toucher on his way through there as well. But that'll open things up. Jack will go back on the tee, the re-spot there. So plenty of room now. It'll be two bowl singles between the two skips.
So what will Gary Kelly come up with this time? Wouldn't surprise me if it's even better than his last effort, if that's possible.
Well, generally you know with the two boys. Barry Lester, he's still watching it. And why wouldn't he be? Look at this. The jack moves, he swaps hands,
incredible.
Draws another toucher.
Incredible.
When you're on a roll, you're on a roll.
Andrew Kelly, born in 1988. International player with success on the lawn and indoors as well.
He needs to get at least second tier, so he's done that. So he will be scoring some points this end, some further points, but currently 30-6, Dandenong Club. They hold shot, and this man on screen, he's already drawn two touches this end, one on the forehand, one on the backhand. Backhand again here with his third bowl. He looks to be diving a bit quick.
Yeah, turned a bit sharply, didn't it?
Vital here, absolutely vital for Andrew Kelly to draw at least second shot.
So we just witnessed here that Gary is in fact human.
Yes.
This man on screen, Andrew Kelly, qualified for the 2018 World Indoor Bowls Championship. He did, by the way, eliminate six times world champion Alex Marshall in that event.
Well, that's good there. Okay, so second and third, they'll get 8 points. Dandenong get 10, so they're still getting points. They're staying in it, and that's the big thing here. Still three ends to go in this clash.
Fast, fresh format. Replay montage.
really set it up, Roger Stevens, right from the start here, this end. But it was that Gary Kelly, that man, the man who continues to deliver. And his first bowl, and he draws that jack around the corner. Roger Stevens, look, his confidence will be growing as the match continues.
So Dandenong Club, they have a nice lead at the completion of two ends. But as we have said so many times before, with this format, anything's possible. Expect the unexpected, because very often it is the unexpected that happens.
As we head to a quick commercial break, now is the time to jump online and give the Ultimate Bowls Championship Facebook page a like. It's a guarantee you won't miss any of the action.
You're watching coverage of the third and final round in the 2019 Ultimate Bowls Championship. Our coverage proudly presented by Ryman Healthcare, Sports Centre, Aero Bowls and the Moama Bowling Club. Welcome back. Fantastic still photo montage there of some of the many people that work diligently behind the scenes and make a massive contribution towards the staging of the Ultimate Bowls Championship. So here we are, Chris Green, commencement of end number three, 40 plays 14. Barry Lester next up.
Yeah, it's time to go here for South Island Storm. They did score 14 points last end, but Dandenong Club added to their 24 on the first end with 16 in the second end. So that score of 40 to 14, 26 margin. South Island Storm need to be scoring this end. Once again, Roger Stevens, if he can lay the platform he did last end, it all comes down to that great man, Gary Kelly, what he can deliver. Because Andrew Kelly played a couple of good ones last end to really change things up. Great shot, Roger. Here we go, well, Roger Stevens.
He almost preempted it. And it wasn't as though Lester didn't come up with a fair bowl of his own to start things. But of course, when the South Island Storm representative stepped up, he did a great job. Lester, very watchful, pulls up a little short, but good enough.
Yeah, that's the thing there, Andrew Kelly just saying to Roger Stevens, once again, draw a toucher out of foot. He lands his own or draws a toucher through, sort of takes away Barry's last bowl. Plus, you always need to be trying to score, especially when you're down by this margin.
South Island Storm, one of two New Zealand teams in the inaugural UBC. The other, the Wellington Hornets, in case you have not seen our coverage before.
Okay. Stevens has really found his groove here now. His last five bowls have all been within a foot.
24 countries around the world carrying the television pictures of the Ultimate Bowls Championship. Great promotion for the sport. Several new teams coming in for the 2020 title.
Just under the line here again, Barry.
Look for another wee touch.
Hey, Roger Stevens here, South Island Storm. Already holding shot, which will be a further 3 points, but would dearly love to get down for the jack here. Oh, he needs to push down to that jack. I don't think he will. He's going to finish on the high side there. We'll get 3 points here and move along to 20. So that margin, just 20 points now.
We go for a walk down the rink with our Steadicam device.
Great to see those TV screens in the background as well. For all the viewers here at Moama, to the spectators and the people in the corporate areas, there's two tiers of corporate area and the big grandstand. There's TVs, four TVs around the rinks. And that gives all the updates as our markers and officials update the scores on the little tablets. Thank you to Samantha Narona, our official for this match.
Yeah, one of the many innovations of the Ultimate Bowls Championship. Full credit to everyone involved to get the tournament together at this standard as quickly as Mark Casey and his crew have done. It's frankly extraordinary.
the technology itself, the scoring technology, I think that's probably one of the best innovations in the sport of bowls over the last couple of years, if not a longer term. We have seen a lot of changes in the last couple of years, but just the fact that you can update it so quickly on the tablets, it goes straight to the screens, and also your screen right there down the bottom left, the score's being updated with bowl by bowl. Gary Kelly once again.
He didn't look that happy when it left his hand.
What can you say about the bloke?
20-point margin. Dandenong and the South Island Storm.
Andrew Kelly here now, down on the backhand, looking to attack the head. Needs some contact here. Well, he gets the jack, and he pushes his own through as well. A very good shot there. Be 3 points. The bowls followed the jack about 2 foot away. South Island Storm move along to 23. Okay, Gary Kelly here. Under a little bit of pressure. First and second shot to South Island Storm. Baz clapping straight away. Always a big supporter of the bowls, these two together. Well, he looks to have drawn it once again. You put the jack wherever you want and I'll draw to it.
Exactly. No mission too hard. So Andrew Kelly.
Really neat shot here, Tappy. I mean, 17 the margin. If he doesn't get shot, it's just second and third. Dandenong actually extend their lead here, so really needs to get shot. He's going to go through the gap, unfortunately. So, big bowl, Gary Kelly. Once again, grabs the shot, so it's 10 points. Second and third, that's 5 and 3, 8 points. So, Dandenong, once again, extend their margin.
Indeed they do. Here at the Moama Bowls Club, truly world-class facility. Another replay montage.
Gary Kelly just keeps delivering, doesn't he? Down here, great weight, just moving around, almost gets back to a toucher, and it forced Andrew Kelly to deliver with his next. Here we see it down on the backhand. He delivered, really changed the header.
It was an awesome comeback in that end from the South Island Storm. Let's see who moves forward in the finals when we return with more from the Ultimate Bowls Championship.
You're watching coverage of the third and final round in the 2019 Ultimate Bowls Championship. Our coverage proudly presented by Ryman Healthcare, Sports Centre, Aero Bowls and the Moama Bowling Club. Good to have your company. Beautiful aerial vision of the city of Moama and the Moama Bowling Club in particular. Right there, you're looking at some of the corporate reserves which have been very well patronised throughout. And we welcome you back to our coverage of quarterfinal number 4, where Dandenong have a very comfortable lead. I'm joined by Chris Green, Barry Lester and Gary Kelly, again combining to put on an absolute exhibition.
It's great to watch. It's great to see South Island Storm. They're still sticking around. They will need a big end here. It all comes back to that first end for Dandenong, as they've delivered so many times, scoring 24 points. The margin now, it's just 19 points. So, look, South Island Storm just been biting into that margin, but Dandenong just continue delivering the big bowls at the right time to hold that margin at bay.
So Roger Stevens in action again. Of course, his wife Bronwyn, the third member of this team, as Chris mentioned earlier. Both Roger and Bronwyn picked up at the draft, whilst, of course, New Zealand blackjack player Andrew Kelly was signed, if you like, as their marquee player. Good place to start, isn't it, Andrew Kelly, if you're going to field a team out of New Zealand?
100%. Once again, though, Roger Stevens, he's been very steady this match. He's really matched Barry Lester. He's won the last two ends, so see if Barry can bounce back here. Barry just knows, though, playing so much with Gary Kelly this year in the UBC, and just exactly what he needs to do. Just get the bowls in the area, give Gary that opportunity. Don't block him up.
Down early. Down.
Looking to get down for the jack.
Get him, mate. Yes, mate.
He has. There we go. Roger Stevens once again. 3 points. Moves along to 34.
The Steadicam, once again, puts you right on the rink with the players. Unprecedented access for the TV coverage of this championship. And that camera and cameraman right behind the mat.
Barry Lester playing weight here down on his forehand for a left-hander, but looks to be outside. Needs connection and good connection on one of his. And unfortunately, probably makes things a little bit worse. Puts Gary back to the draw, if anything, now around those bowls. Roger Stevens, he'll change hands here. As always, if you're interested in entering a team in the UBC, just contact the CEO. It's Mark at Ultimate Bowls Championship. com.au.
Yep, always an opportunity for you to enter a team. If you're a massive bowls fan and want to be involved, you can even be a part of syndicate, or a syndicate rather, in this championship. Again, as we walk down towards the head.
That final bowl, that's put Gary playing big weight now, trying to make good connection here. And he's taken two of the bowls out, so he'd be very happy with that.
Even if he doesn't necessarily look it.
Yeah. 37 South Island Storm now. Look at that margin. It's just 13 points. That's just first and third shot.
That's fantastic. It says everything about this format and the quality of player involved. They're coming back.
Well, you did say expect the unexpected. Unfortunately there, Andrew Kelly just dropped short. That was his chance to apply the pressure. Gary Kelly now, after a full-blooded drive on his forehand, he removed two bowls. He's now got a foot to draw himself.
Again, he didn't look that happy as the bowl left his hand. I think his mood's getting better.
There'd be a lot of bowlers out there who'd be happy with that after a full-blooded drive.
Absolutely.
So Andrew Kelly here needs to add a second shot. At worst, get third shot. He needs to have two of the first three here. Really apply that pressure to Gary Kelly.
Short again.
Now, this is not the end where you want to go walkabouts. Just falling short. Great line there.
Been a wonderful quarterfinal series. At this, the third round of the championship. Seen some fabulous games. It augurs well for the semis. Coverage of the semi-finals commencing right here next week. Make sure you don't miss it. Semi-final one.
Well, he needs to make some solid contact on these bowls, but there's going to be plenty of room here. Okay. Well, here we go. There's potential here. First and second shot to South Island Storm. That'll be 15, moving along to 52. And then third shot for Dandenong will be 53. There'll be 1 point in it. But he needs to draw second shot here. Really give himself a chance. It's been some fight here from the South Island Storm. Can he drop in? Andrew Kelly needs his bowl to roll towards a jack. No. So it's just hung out there. Looks like it's still be first and third. So that'll give him a solid 13 points. Barry Lester just getting the fingers out there just to have a quick look. As we see Gary Kelly, big weight here, really changed things up. Roger Stevens produced three great bowls to hold first, second and third following the crossover. Removal of one, two bowls there. Just one down.
Great pitches. Fantastic stuff. Some super slow motion vision thrown in. One of the world's great players and his expressions.
Okay, Baz has got the tape out now, so it does look like first and third, 50 to 55, just 5 points in it, one in remaining in this quarterfinal. Who would have thought after the start from Dandenong? Don't go anywhere, plenty more action coming right up, fifth and final end.
If you're keen to show your support for your favourite team, jump onto the Sports Centre or UBC website now and pick up some of the fantastic merchandise. All sizes, all colours are available. Thanks to the guys at Sports Centre.
You're watching coverage of the third and final round in the 2019 Ultimate Bowls Championship. Our coverage proudly presented by Ryman Healthcare, Sports Centre, Aero Bowls and the Moama Bowling Club.
Welcome back to the Moama Bowling Club, where the Dandenong team have a 5-point lead over the South Island Storm. There's absolutely nothing in it as we go into this final end. Let's go down to the rink.
Oh, I think Ebony might be having a good time, and how could she not be? 5-point margin separating these teams, heading into end number five, the final end, of course. And you can see there are plenty of fans in here loving this.
It's great to see all the fans here at the UBC as well, and we've got a wide range of ages as well and bowls experiences here. And we've also got people in our corporate, the supporters and the sponsors for different range of either sides in the event or the event itself. And it's great to see everyone here at Moama. And as you said, you'd be switched on. 5 points the difference here, fifth and final end, quarterfinal number four. The winner of this moves through to the semi-finals.
The No Secrets anthem in the background. We see Barry Lester in action again. Scoreline has tightened up so much. Full credit to South Island Storm.
Well, I put it down to Roger Stevens. He has led remarkably. Second end, he really jumped on. Second, third, fourth end, he's just absolutely brilliant.
That's what it's all about, isn't it? Good players lifting and becoming even better. Stepping up for the occasion. On the big stage.
They've always called bowls a game of inches, and especially in this format right now, and there's just those sort of points on offer and just missing the jack. That could be the difference between winning and losing with the points on offer, 3 points for a toucher.
Baz likes having a good look here.
He's almost out in the crowd, as we see in set there.
Oh! You'll get him, mate. Well, there's an example of that old adage you just uttered. Game of inches, all right. So the business end of this final, quarter-final.
Yeah, two huge bowls here. One from Stevens, one from Lester. Needs to try and, well, he's not going to hold shot here. So this is, look, this is really good here for Dandenong Club. They're currently holding shot. If they were to get a toucher here, courtesy of Barry Lester, be a further 3 points. Current margin is five. Be 3 points for the crossover. You can't fault Roger Stevens, though, for trying to land the bowls or trail the jack there. He gave his bowls a chance, so Andrew Kelly will have options there for the South Island Storm.
So what it's all about here, Chris, is very simply which team will cope with the pressure. Yes. In the run home here.
Okay, good replay there. The boys crossing over once again. They know what they're doing. Barry and Gaz, calm as anything. The South Island Storm, what a fight back. You know I love my scoring, Tappy. Currently 8 points the margin. First and third to South Island Storm. That'd be 13 points, 5 points to Dandenong. And both sides would finish on 63, provided there is no touches. Or even amount of touches. And there's the first toucher. 3 points, the margin back to just five.
Great vision. You're right in the thick of it, aren't you? So Lester looking over the head as his teammate Gary Kelly attempts some more magic.
Well, right here now for Dandenong, it'll come back to actually one of Barry's favourite things in bowls, and the strength in numbers. The big thing about strength in numbers with the UBC is obviously scoring points at the conclusion of end. So if they were good enough here to score second and third shot without any further touches from South Island Storm, Dandenong moved forward. But Andrew Kelly trying to follow up his first bowl, which was a toucher just shy of the jack. Unfortunately, a little bit like last end.
Love listening to the player banter. Obviously the players are mic'd up. You can hear it as a part of the coverage. It does give you a terrific insight into
Well, I guess the theatre of the occasion.
Gary Kelly.
Ooh.
Very good shot.
58-53. Final in.
Well, final bowl here for Andrew Kelly for this end, this match, possibly this event and this campaign in the UBC.
Again, the quarterfinals living right up to expectation, in fact, exceeding expectation.
He's following it. He is following it. He needs it to run. Needs it to hurry. Looks like it's falling short. Just a little bit of a kick there to try and maybe push it up, but look, he won't get away with that as the boys are shaking hands there. High fives all around.
So Dandenong has won a thrilling quarterfinal, and so the teams for our semi-finals, coverage commencing next week, have now been decided. We'll show you that information in just a moment. Replay and montage, Andrew Kelly and Roger Stevens, hold your head high. A tremendous effort against some fairly lofty opponents in Dandenong Club. And once again, outstanding exhibition of bowls. Let's head down to Georgia White.
The Dandenong boys have done it again. What a thrilling match, down right to the wire there. What sort of preparation do you have coming into a match like this in this stage of the finals, knowing that, you know, they're the underdog and they're trying to beat you?
Oh, yeah, I was really impressed the way Roger started off. He played really well, gave all his bowls a chance. And, yeah, for me, because I wasn't quite nailing it, it was about just giving my bowls a chance in past the jack. And that's what you have to do. If you're not on it, you need to be past to give the skippers a bit of a chance. So that's really the prep going into it. Once again, I wasn't quite nailing it, but just trying to help the big man out when I can. And really, really impressed with the way they played. It was a good game.
And thrilling bowls from you. So many touches, Gary. Is this a combination we'll see going through the rest of the games?
I've played a few big balls in the game there, so yeah, it's always great to do that. You gain confidence from that there. The Barry and Gary, we go well. I think we'll be taking into a semi-final as well, and just hopefully we can perform.
There we go, Barry and Gary going through the semi-final for Dandenong Club. Back to you guys in the commentary box.
Thank you, Georgia White, a very good player in her own right. There's the semi-finals, folks. Broadbeach and the Borough boys, and Exodus against Dandenong. They are mouth-watering prospects, aren't they?
Absolutely. I thought quarterfinal 1-3 was good, but we just saw quarterfinal 4 and it was brilliant. But next week, don't forget to tune in for a Broadbeach Bulls up against the Borough boys, who I like to call the Party Boys, in semi-final number 1. And it is mouth-watering. Barry Lester here, Dandenong. Well, they're going to be hard to beat.
Yeah, they are the benchmark. There's no question about that.
Yeah, South Island Storm, though, full credit to them. And look, it's a great way to finish the UBC, the first year off 2020. Be looking forward to big things from South Island Storm.
Well done, Chris Green. Stellar contribution, as always. Thank you, folks. Wherever you've been watching our coverage around the world, it's been good to have you with us. Join us next week for semi-final number... Thank you.